Namaste, good morning everyone. I am Anil Yadav on the behalf of the Jati School family, and we are running the classes in the next lecture. I am going to start the compulsory mathematics of class 10, and here we are in unit 4, that is algebra. I am algebra, sorted order, factorization. Then indices are there which have been already done, but we are going to start about the simultaneous equation, simultaneous linear equation. Yes, and here I have written the definition. At first, look here, what is simultaneous equation? When two or more equations are satisfied, yes, when two or more equations are satisfied by the same values of the unknown quantities, they are called the simultaneous equation. Yes. And simultaneous equation, that means what? Simultaneous linear equation can be written in the form like this: ax plus by plus c equals to 0. Yes, this is the type of the simultaneous linear equation where a, b and c are the constant number and x, y are two variable over there. Yes, so it said that unknown quantities, that means what? X and Y are the unknown quantities, two unknown quantities, yes. And when we get the values of this X and Y, yes, if we have the two equation, and when we get the values of this X and Y, and when we put that values in the same equation, then it satisfies, no? That's why we said that when two or more equation, that means more than two, if two unknown variables are there, then two equation must be related. If three are there, then three equations should be related. Yes. So when two or more equations are satisfied by the same value of the unknown quantities, that means first equation also, second equation also, they are satisfied with the same value x and y. Yes. Unknown quantity, they are called the simultaneous equation. And this about that, and about the simultaneous equation, we have already discussed in class 9 also, in grade 9 also, and there are three methods to solve the simultaneous linear equation of two unknown quantities, which we have already discussed in class 9, yes? And they are the elimination method, substitution method, and graphical method. Yes, these three methods which we have already discussed in class 9, yes? And we are not going to do the elimination, we are not going to only do the elimination, substitution, and graphical way, that means of the equation only, but in class 10 we are going to make the equation or simultaneous equation from the word problem. Word problem are given there, and we are going to make the equation at first. Yes, on the basis of the case, on the basis of the condition, or according to the question, we make at first, and then only we use the idea or knowledge gained from class 9 about the elimination, substitution, or graphical, and we are going to use only elimination and substitution. No? For the graphically, it takes time, we have to insert in the graph. Yes, that's why we use just elimination and substitution. And one example I have written here, look at 2x plus y equals to 8, and 3x minus 2y equals to 5. X and y, they are the unknown quantities, x and y, they are the unknown quantities. Two unknown quantities there and two equation is given here. Yes. Now we are going to solve this. No? The value of x and y. How to find the value of x and y? And just I will do add for the elimination method, substitution, and such a hint about that. Yes. And that is. Then only we'll go through the how to mix the word problem into the equation. Yes. Now for that, look here. It is given that. Yes, at first we are going to by using elimination method. Yes, for that we have what here 2x plus y equals to 8 is given. Yes, this is our first equation, and then 3x minus 2y equals to 5 is given, that is the second equation. Yes, that is a nut. Yes. That means we are going to do this example by elimination at first. Elimination means what? That means we are going to eliminate any term. eliminate के निकालने त्यागता हटाऊंगे yes we have to do the cancelling word no eliminate that any one term either x we are going to eliminate from the both equation or y and for that to do the elimination we have to do the coefficient of the variable no here for the x 3 is the coefficient for x 3 is the coefficient yes and this coefficient must be same then only we can watch eliminate them yes similarly for y also we have to what eliminate or we have to we must have the coefficient same then only we can eliminate y yes and it is easy now 2x is here 3x is here so no equal coefficient here y and minus 2 is here yes or not so if you multiply the equation first with 2 then we get what 2 2 is 4 2 1 is 2 and 2 8 is 16 over here and we get 2 as the coefficient of y in the first equation and in second equation 2 is the coefficient that is coefficient of y is similar or not that is same term 2 yes so that is our easy so we multiply this equation with 2 and why doing this that multiply equation first by 2 and then and adding equation first and second yes let's multiply with these two and first these two multiply with all the three terms no 2 2 is 4 x 2 1 is 2 plus 2 1 is 2 equals to 2 8 is 16 yes we get this and we have what 3 x minus 2 y equals to 5 that is enough and we are adding the equation first and second so let's add them and while adding no need to change the sign yes now look here 4x plus 3x we get what 7x and plus 2x minus 2x that means the coefficient is same and variables are same so we can cancel them that means we eliminate y over here yes so we get what 7x equals to what 16 plus 5 we get 21 yes now 7 is multiplied here and go this side then it become what divide upon 7 yes again yes and x equals to 7 3 is 21 7 on the yes and so we get 3 that is yes the value of therefore the value of x is 3 and 1 and again now we are going to find the value of y just we get the value of x only now it's time to find the value of y for that either we put the value of x in equation original equation yes original equation first or in second yes so for that putting the value x equals to 3 in equation which one we like yes let's put in equation first yes then we have what 2x plus y equals to 8 is there and put x equals to 3 2 into 3 plus y equals to 8 that means 6 plus y equals to 8 here it is plus yes when it goes to other side then it become minus 8 minus 6 we get the value of 2 and we have to put all over here yes this is and we get the value of x equals to 3 y equals to 2 yes and lastly we get the conclusion and was the value of x and y are 3 and 2 respectively yes or no like this and look that 3 and 2 these two values satisfy both equation or not let's put here 2 3 is 6 6 plus 2 we get 8 yes similarly same 3 3 is 9 minus 2 2 is 4 9 minus 4 we get 500. These two satisfy the unknown quantities, you know. We get the values of the unknown quantity and they satisfy both equation and that. That means the definition is like that, no? And we did that. And this is the elimination method. We did this as the elimination. This is the elimination method. And now for the substitution, yes? For the substitution of the same question, yes? We are going to, for the substitution, look at. And this we have already discussed in class 9. Just I am revising that, yes? For the substitution method, from the equation first, yes? We have to substitute the value. From the equation first, we are going to find the value of x or y, and that value of x or y we have to keep in equation second, and then we get the value of one term, yes, either x or y, which we are going to substitute over here, yes. So for the substitution, from equation first, yes, we have what? 2x plus y equals 2h, yes, so y equals to what? 8 minus 2x, 2x is positive over here and it goes to next side and it becomes minus 2x, and let's think this as the third equation. This is our third equation, and now we are going to put the value of y equals to 8 minus 2x in equation second in the place of y, yes. So putting the value of y equals to 8 minus 2x in equation second, yes, we get, that means 2x minus 2, in place of y we are going to put 8 minus 2x equals to 5, that is our, yes. Now this 3x remain the same, minus this 2. Now this 2 is here and here got it, that means multiply is here, no? So this 2 multiply with 8 also for minus 2 also, so it become what? Minus 16 minus minus plus 2 to the 4x equals to 5, that is, yes. Now add the algebraic term, yes. Now 3x and 4x is there, 3x and 4x they are in the positive sign, so 3 plus 4 we get the 7x, and 16 is negative, yes, and when it goes to that side then it become positive, so we get what? 5 plus 16, yes, that means 7x equals to 21, yes or not? And x equals to what? 21 upon 7. 7 is multiplied over here and goes to that side and it becomes divided. Yes or not? Now x equals to 3. We get the value of x equals to 3. Yes? Now to get the value of y, we have the y equals to 8 minus 2x. We get the equation third and put this value in equation third, directly we get the value y. Yes? So let's put that. Putting the value of x equals to 3 in equation third, yes, in equation third we get what? Y equals to 8 minus 2 into 3, that means what? 8 minus 6, that is 2, yes, we get the value. Same in the elimination method also, we get the value x equals to 3 and y equals to 2. Similarly, in the substitution method also we get the same value, and in the graphical method also we get the same value, no? And these things we have already discussed in class 9. Just I will revise this, no? And we are going to, in this class also, in class 10 also, we are going to do either the elimination or substitution, but we do not have the equation at first. We have the word problem, yes, such a word problem are given, and we are going to make the equation from the word problem at first, and then by applying the condition, and then only we solve them either by elimination or substitution method. And this simultaneous linear equation, in the exam point of view, it contains 4 marks, no? Sometimes it may exceed the 2 marks, but 4 marks, much more time, no? In 4 marks it comes, yes? In exam point of view. And this, that is one, in the graphical method, just we, from, like from the equation first and second, we find the value of x and y, and we put the coordinate over there and plot in the graph, no? And then when we get the intersection of such point, and that is the value of x and y. Yes, and this is the this about the simultaneous equation which we have already discussed in class 9. Just I revise this. Yes, I am coming. That is in coming period. In coming yes classes, we discuss about how to make the word problem, sorry, word problem into the equation by applying the condition, and then only we will solve them. And there are, that is four, five types are there. Yes, and if you know that, that is sufficient for the simultaneous equation. No? And this was for today. Thank you for watching this.